Hi, I'm Pat from VMOD 3D Library. Today, we're going to learn about applying VMOD's textures to the Blender Cycles renderer. Before we begin, let's take a look at the final render. You can achieve a photorealistic look like this by using VMOD's textures in Blender Cycles, along with creating basic nodes and adjusting parameters. Let's get started. Here's today's texture. P.S. You can download it for free if you sign up for VMOD 3D Library now. Let's look at the texture list. Now we have downloaded all the textures for rendering. In addition to the 7 PBR maps, you can also see the mask maps. But we'll be using 5 PBR maps today, and we're going to learn about mask maps in another video, so please stay tuned. In this tutorial, we will be utilizing the base, normal, displacement, roughness, and ambient occlusion map among the 7 available PBR maps, excluding the metallic and alpha map. For rendering, here's an object in its default setting. Click on the editor type icon located in the top left corner, and switch it to Asset Browser in the data section. For this particular scene, I added the HDRI light and area light with normal contrast. Here's the render setting. We'll be working with nodes in Blender's basic shading layout. We'll select principled BSDF material for the base material. If you can't see the nodes, press the home button on your keyboard to place the node in the center. Now, let's import the textures. Simply drag and drop from the downloaded texture folder. I'm putting them in orders of base map, ambient occlusion map, roughness map, normal map, and displacement map. Let's change the viewport shading to rendered display. I'll begin connecting textures, starting from the base map. Press Shift A to open the node add pop-up. Search for mix, then create a mix node. Using the ambient occlusion map with mix, you can add additional intricacy of the light and shadow areas of the fabric. After creating the mix node, change float to color and mix to multiply. And set the factor value to 1. Then connect A to the base map and B to the ambient occlusion map. And don't forget to connect result to the base color. Next up, connect the roughness map to the material roughness port. For the normal map, press Shift A to create a normal node and connect it. Connect color to color and normal to normal and set it to UV map. For the displacement map, create a displacement node, connect to height input, and connect to the displacement port of material output. Before fine-tuning the specific parameters of each map, let's adjust the scale first. Press Shift A to create a mapping node. Connect the vector output of the created mapping node to each map's vector input. And then, create a texture coordinate node. Connect UV output to the vector input of the mapping node. You can now adjust the scale by uniformly increasing or decreasing the X, Y, and Z values of the mapping node scale. Putting it to 5 looks good to me. Now, it's time to refine some details of each map. Let's begin with the roughness map first, as we will make adjustments to the base map and ambient occlusion map right before the final rendering stage. Press Shift A to create a color ramp node and connect to it. Color ramp is a feature that allows you to visualize a range of colors in a gradient format. By selecting the black gradient and adjusting the color bar below, you can control the roughness of the darker areas in the roughness map. Adjusting the white gradient will modify the roughness of the lighter areas in the roughness map. Since the roughness map is grayscale, the adjustments are confined to the spectrum between black and white. I think this looks nice. The normal map looks fine, so I won't make any changes now. If necessary, you can adjust the strength on the normal map node. Before modifying the displacement map, let's increase the subdivision level a bit, as the object has few meshes. Subdivision is a feature that breaks up or rounds polygons to create a smoother look for objects with fewer meshes. Click on the modifiers icon to raise the level's viewport from 0 to 2. Be careful not to raise it too much, as it can significantly slow down the process and cause disruptions. Raising the subdivision did the trick. This is exactly what I wanted. I'll skip modifying the displacement map for now. Again, you can adjust the mid-level and scale on the displacement node if necessary. We're going to use the Sheen feature, since this is a corduroy fabric. If you look at the principled BSDF material, you can see sheen and sheen tint in the middle. Sheen is a function that adds a subtle sheen-like reflections around the edges, giving a realistic cloth-like appearance. Corduroy fabric is typically a soft and lustrous fabric like velvet, so we are utilizing the sheen feature to effectively display this characteristic. Sheen tint is used with the sheen function and blends white with the base color for a glossy reflection. First, let's find sheen value we want. It looks like the maximum value of the sheen intensity is 1, but you can put any numbers like 20 or minus 4000. I'll put this about 40. Next, I'll raise the sheen tint value to achieve a color that closely matches the base color. I'll put this to 1 to add a little bit of violet. Please keep in mind that increasing the sheen tint value will make it closely resemble the base color, and decreasing it will result in a whiter appearance. We're done with applying the sheen, but now it looks like we need to modify the displacement map and the normal map. It doesn't look like corduroy, because the strength of the displacement map is too much. So I'll reduce the strength here. To do so, set the displacement mid-level to 0.12, and scale to 0.3, and you can see the sheen looks more natural. Next, I'll increase the strength on the normal map node to give some more details. Raise it to 2.5, and now it looks much better. When working with nodes, it's better to start with overall adjustments before raising values, and then gradually increase the strength of the map you want to emphasize. Today we learned about how to use VMOD's textures in Blender Cycles. If you're using Eevee Renderer, change the render view setting to Eevee and the parameters a bit, then you can get a similar result. Eevee Renderer offers faster rendering speeds than Cycles Renderer, but has limitations in accurately representing some shaders. You can download the project file, which includes the object used for rendering and the lighting settings, from the VMOD 3D Library tutorial page. Click on Show More for additional details. If you enjoyed this video, don't forget to hit the like button and subscribe our channel. See you next time.